The delivery truck just pulled away and I could talk about Interfit Photographic's new Honey Badger strobe. Inside the box you'll find the Honey Badger, a power cord, a sync cord, an instruction manual, two spare fuses, and a nifty pop-up 24-inch square softbox. Let's start with the Honey Badger itself. Bright yellow, compact and lightweight. Despite the lightweight, it feels solid. Removing the protective cover over the front, we see there's a glass diffuser dome over the flash tube and the 60-watt LED modeling lamp, which puts out as much light as the typical 250-watt quartz lamp found in other strobe units, but with very little heat. The Honey Badger uses the industry standard S mount for modifiers, so if you have an Interfit S1, you can use the same softboxes and other modifiers. But this mount looks different. The black ring here around the mount allows you to use pop-up modifiers that you might already have for your speed lights. And to top that off, the Honey Badger comes with a 24-inch square pop-up softbox that fits right onto the flash with no need for a separate speed ring. Another nice feature is that the Honey Badger has a built-in radio receiver that works with the same triggers as the S1 if you already have one. There's also a new remote available for the Honey Badger. The remote lets you control the power of the light unit over its 7-stop range, as well as setting the modeling lamp to on, off, and proportional. And it'll let you turn the ready beep on and off. If you have multiple lights, you can also set up groups and channels to control them individually. So what about performance? The Honey Badger has 320 watt-seconds of power that is adjustable in 1/10-stop increments over a 7-stop range. It can be dialed all the way down to 5 watt-seconds for when you need a pop-up flash but want to photograph at wider open apertures. I put the included softbox on the lamp head and set it up 24 inches from my subject, and my meter reads F32 at full power. Dialed down, I get to F4.0. And if I pull the light back a little bit, I even get down to F2.8 at ISO 100. And recycle time? 1 second at full power, and faster as you lower the power. It won't quite keep up with the motor drive, but you should be able to get a couple of frames per second if needed. The unit is fan-cooled and can take an 8mm umbrella shaft, making it compatible with my all-time favorite Fotex soft lighters. Over the next few days, I plan to put the Honey Badger through its paces and studio sessions. More on that to come. For now, it's time to go and make some photographs and have some fun. Cheers!